game is like Crazy Taxi. It's where you, it's a taxi kind of service game, and you go and collect as much money as humanly possible. And this is the Simpsons version. You got Road Rage, Sunday Drive, where you just explore Springfield as your favorite character. Different mission mode, which you got different missions. I'm gonna do Road Rage, obviously. And I'm gonna do some fun stuff. Homer, you got Bart and the Soapbox Racer, yeah, the Marcus Camaro SUV, Lisa has a crazy electric car, let's just say, Grandpa Simpson and his Shriner's cart, whatever that Shriner is, I have no clue, kind of weird sounding, but, Skipper Willie's tractor. A Pooh Pontiac Firebird, which for copyright reasons I can't say, but it's, you know, basically Pontiac Firebird. I just can't use the name to the copyright, you know, laws. Also, a school bus. How about weird looking school buses? There's no roof, but. Chief Wiggum's police car. Flanders station wagon. Homer's Mr. Plow. It's a funny, funny character. I used to play as Mr. Plow all the time as a kid. Snake's Little Bandit, which is basically a 1969 Dodge Charger. Basically, they just, again, copyright, they can't say it, but that's basically what the car is based on. And then Professor Fink's flying car. Just a camera, hello. Oh, yeah, from the play. That's a certain strategy I have where I scored the high score I got was $55,000 in the game. So I'm going to show you how to do this. Terrace, Entertainment District, Springfield Dam, Nuclear Power Plant, Downtown, but I didn't unlock Springfield Mountains yet. Now, of course, I've been playing this since I was a kid, but my copy got scratched up to where it stopped working, because as a kid, I was bad at taking care of desks. So I went to a local game store that has used all these old games, and I found this copy. Never been opened, and it was, you know, the disc had completely. For like $20, because even though this is, you know, old, these, you know, these games are hard to find, so of course they hold their value. And plus, this was a popular one too. Road Rage. Another one was good. One was Hit and Run, which I'm trying to work on getting. Anyway, and it's interesting about this is that the people made Crazy Taxi actually sued the people that made this game due to being so similar to Crazy Taxi. So that's all long. So, of course, it's all a long story. But if you want, I can do a whole video explaining all that, you know, all that stuff. But it'll have to be in the review because that'd be a bit of a storyline. You pick people up, you drop them off. Because Mr. Burns bought the Springfield Bus Company, and he's putting radiation from the power plant in it. He's threatening the public health. So all the Simpsons characters are working together to put a stop to him and build up that money so they can purchase the bus company from Mr. Burns and beat out outdo his business. And I have a secret tactic to where, because usually in a game it's hard to score past 10,000, 10,000 to 12,000, but I have a secret tactic that, and obviously it works for different people, but for me, my gameplay style, I found a way that works. That actually helps me to score ridiculous amounts. And stuff. Not to show you. And I'll mention it to the early, so that way you guys That's why sometimes I drive on the grass. It's so much simpler. And it gets you there a lot quicker. And you usually get bonuses. You'll get a bonus. You'll get a bonus deal you'll have to have, for instance. Or if you avoid traffic and don't hit them, like I'm doing now, you'll actually get $250 in 5 seconds. Instead of $100 for going fast and then 3 seconds extra. You're gonna get all sorts of areas you can run people over. It's kind of funny sometimes. You can knock stuff down. You got the obviously non-playable characters being the cars. And you also have Mr. Burns who drives his limousine who keeps trying to crash into you. So you have to be good at maneuvering. Because he will try to crash. You got a nice little Dukes of Hazzard jump here, which is kind of fun. And usually I'll go the other way, but with my strategy to make a lot of money, I do it this way. Because then I can keep building up that time on the clock. And that's that bus, or as I call it, the evil bus. Because the bus tries to crash into you too, to make it to purpose, on purpose, which is on purpose. Because they want to make it harder for you to win. Win a lot of cash. So you get very little money. Or that's another bonus. If you can destroy enough things, you get $1,000 cold hard cash in the game. And you can just be random things. You just gotta destroy things. Doesn't matter what it is. And basically, the path, as you can see, the path I'm doing, I basically repeat it over and over and over and over and over and over again. Like nonstop. I may do it, change it up a little, just a small bit with the passengers, just to switch things up, because it gets boring doing the same path over and over again, and kind of annoying. But it's my strategy, and how you make a lot of cash, which I didn't discover until recently. Because as a kid, I'm like, and I used to see people score crazy amounts, I'm like, how are these people doing that? I'm making like, as a kid, I remember the highest I did was, what, maybe like 12,000-13,000 being... Because they said that 12,000 is the highest record for the, you know, for you to beat. And I used to somewhat be as a kid, but I had a hard time with it. Not until I'm an adult that I figured I was really thinking about it. And thinking like, what can I do for a strategy? And I was going on the Sunday drive to practice. Since you don't have a time limit and you don't have money amount thing. On Sunday drive you can still pick the passengers up, but and you know it's like a little practice mode. I felt this strategy. I'm like, I should try that on Road Rage mode, which is what I'm doing now, and see if it works. And what do you know, it actually worked, and I ended up scoring crazy amounts of money. I was making like 3 to 4 times the normal amount of points I normally would make in the game. So I'm like, jeepers, that's pretty good. And I was thinking, you know what I should do? I should do it for a video. I mean, I wanted to do this for a video anyway to see if you guys like it or not. For those who like the video game, play ASMR. But also, I'm like, geez, I should do it for a video, because what deserve people who play this game? Well, I have to struggle with the same thing I do. Yeah, it's a very well show that strategy, because I don't know if it's a well-known strategy or not. But it's something I thought of when playing it, so I figured I should share it with the world. And see what other gamers think, and just other people in general. Stuff. Like I said, it's a pretty fun game. I played Crazy Taxi in the arcade, but I didn't know until I was an adult. Because a friend of mine actually bought Crazy Taxi for PlayStation 2. And I was like, Crazy Taxi's on PlayStation 2? And it was weird, because as a kid, I should have known that, because I played that Crazy Taxi in the arcade. Because it was originally an arcade game before it was on the PS2. And before it went on console. And I remember recently, I'm like, oh, jeez. I should get the Crazy Taxi, and I'm watching him play it. I'm like, oh, this is fun. This is pretty fun stuff. Good stuff. So, my geez, I should play this game. I should play that, you know, and get it and play it and see. That'll be fun. And of course, I'm currently working on getting Crazy Taxi to do it for the, you know, be like older generation or young generation doesn't know what Crazy Taxi is. And just do it as a video in general for those who like the video game playing ASMR. And the local game store I go to has a copy of Crazy Taxi, but when I went there, they only had the box and everything, and I'm like, It's kind of weird too, because they're charging like $12 for the game, but then when you go there, there's no box, I mean, no disc. Like, I'm sitting there like thinking to myself, you guys know that there's no disc, but yet you're charging one for $13 and another one for $16, but both copies have no disc in it. And I've seen game stores sell just a box. There's like nowhere near that amount. Usually it's like maybe a few dollars, maybe with the box and manual. So I'm still on the hunt, looking for a Crazy Taxi. Eventually I'm gonna try to get on like eBay or Amazon probably, because that's the only places that I've actually, you know, seen it on, to where you can actually get, you know, the game. Oh, and before I forget too, I also have a special package from Amazon today. I have a new hat that I'll be featuring in a video. And if you guys, I may do a review video of it just for the heck of it. But it's something that's specifically for Sunday Service ASMR, where, as you know, I usually wear a Batman hat or ASMR Wolf hat. I try to lean away from the Batman hat to make it more professional and respectful, being that I'm talking about Jesus and God and the Bible. I have the church shirts, but I don't have a church hat. I'm like, I kind of need a hat to go with it. So me and the team are looking, and we actually found a Jesus hat with a cross on it. And it's a really nice design, too. So I'm going to definitely be wearing that for Christian Wolf Bibles. I mean, for Sunday Service ASMR. Well, I already said, so I might as well mention what Christian Wolf Bible Study says. It's another channel I have where I talk about, you know, the Bible and all that stuff. I have a TikTok for it, but of course, it's just normal videos, just talking about the Bible and preaching and stuff. And of course, TikTok, for whatever reason, deleted all my Christian videos. And now I had to start it all from fresh. YouTube, it was fine, but of course, TikTok, of course. Which doesn't surprise me, because there's a lot of them. For some reason, some Christians, like, a lot of times they do the videos and TikTok, what they call shadow banning them and trying canceling them and stuff. Which I can imagine is probably because they don't agree, which is usually the main reason why a lot, you know, social media does that, which I don't agree with per se. Since everybody should have a voice. But, you know, but I'm working on getting that started all over again with it. Everything else. And eventually I'm working on getting product stuff for that, but that's, you know, side project I'm still working on. But my main focus is here on ASMR and stuff. And yeah, hopefully enjoying the game so far. And I got some interesting videos for the rest of the week too. I went to Dollar Tree and I got a whole bunch of random different things that I could do for reviewing. And some of the stuff that so I got a few things that are good, you know, for the younger audience. As I have some kids who watch my ASMR stuff, going to YouTube, my YouTube studio statistics. And so I got some for some films as well, which I hope the adults will enjoy it too, of course. Which is part of the reason why I did the animal thing, because it was something that I know kids will enjoy. It'd be good. And it'd be good educational thing. So maybe like if teachers want to show it to their students, or this is learning tools, or just parents, or whoever, really, in general. And just a general interesting video as part of like an educational slash, like, I don't know, like virtual school kind of ASMR kind of thing. I figured it was a trial and see, and these guys seem to like it. So I could definitely look into doing more like an educational series of ASMR videos. We're getting towards the end of this video. Enjoy this video. Of course, as you see there, sometimes there's not a person there, so to bypass the trick, I just pick this guy up, being Dr. Nick, and I bring him, and then once I come back around for another lap to that same spot, there will be somebody there. So I could do that, another tactic, which is how the game gets you. They try to hide the character and not put somebody there to kind of trick you, which is probably, I can imagine, to make you screw up, which I won't be surprised. Difficult, but It's easy to get past that part. It's, you know, pretty fairly easy. And as you can see, it's a fairly easy game. Easy for the kids to play and stuff. Really, or just a family in general. A really fun game. Oops, of course I screwed up there a little bit, but. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you want, let me know, make sure let me know in the comments below. If you want, I can get when I get the hit and run game, I can do a video review of that Simpsons game too. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and share my video so other people will see it. I hope you enjoyed this video of me reviewing the Simpsons Road Rage ASMR. And